Legislative Resolution Number 232 by Senator Kennedy, remembering and honoring the lives of the 13 victims of Buffalo's November winter storm of 2014.
I'm going to ask for some silence in the House, please. Senator Kennedy.
Yes, thank you, Mr. President. As we prepare for a winter storm today of unprecedented measure that's going to hit the Northeast, I rise to remember and honor the 13 victims of Buffalo's November storm just this past 2014. We send our thoughts and prayers to the families and friends as they mourn the loss of their loved ones. On the evening of Monday, November 17th, an epic winter storm began that would devastate Buffalo and all of Western New York. Lasting 4 days, millions of dollars would be spent in cleanup and rescue operations, making this one of the costliest storms in regional history. But the financial cost pales in comparison to the human cost. There are 13 families with an empty seat at the table and a hole in their heart that will never be filled. Today, we join the entire Western New York community as we regretfully mourn and remember the lives lost. Stephen H. Thomas, Cynthia Woodrick, Michael N. Strachan, Lyle H. Hall Sr., Ruth R. Snyder, Valentin L. Mosiak, John Jack Boyce, James A. Thomas Sr., Jan Barsom, David M. Denneke, Donald J. Abate, Robert M. Cedar, and Delancey Scott, who all passed away as a result of this devastating storm. Mr. Scott's mother, Barnett Burton, is here with us today on the Senate floor as we honor the memory of her firstborn son. Thank you very much for joining us here today in your son's memory. We as a chamber offer our most sincere regrets and most heartfelt condolences on your loss. We mourn all of the lives lost as a city, as a region, and as a state. While we cannot bring back their loved ones, families of the victims of the storm can take comfort knowing that their legacy will live on. Even in the darkest points of the storm, there were still points of light. During this storm, our community banded together in a tremendous way. We saw people not only helping friends and family, but aiding neighbors and even strangers in their time of need. On my street in South Buffalo, we were snowed in for 4 days. It was tough, but it brought us all closer together. Neighbors checked in on seniors, making sure that they were warm and fed. Families got together for meals all throughout our regions, and we all helped shovel and clear snow. From neighbors helping each other to dig out their homes, to residents taking in a stranded traveler, to firemen in South Buffalo helping to deliver a baby, we were reminded that the city of Buffalo is truly the city of good neighbors. It was an extremely difficult time, but we came together as neighbors, as a state, as a community to help one another. Tragically, there were those whose lives were lost in this unprecedented disaster. As we honor them today, their families can rest assured that their memory will live on in perpetuity. Again, Mr. President, I thank you for the privilege, and we honor those who were lost in the November storm. May they rest in peace. Thank you, Mr.
Thank you,
President.
Senator Kennedy. Senator Ort.
I'd like to thank Senator Kennedy and his staff for helping us bring today this recognition to those we lost in November's tragic storm. And of course, our thoughts are with our downstate colleagues and fellow New Yorkers who are currently in the path of today's winter storm. I would like to personally also welcome one of my constituents, Niagara Falls resident, Ms. Barnett Burton. Barnett got on a train this morning at 6:30 to join us here, and she will turn around and take a 6-hour train ride home. The reason she's here, of course, is to honor her son, Delancey Scott, who we lost in November's storm. Delancey was a veteran of the New York Army National Guard and leaves behind a daughter. She mentioned to me that Delancey passed away alone, and she wanted to be here today so that in a small way she would be with him here as we recognize his life and legacy. And so I want to thank you for coming, and I hope that our actions today will not only recognize those we lost, not just in Niagara County, but across Western New York, but also bring some closure, help with the grieving process, and bring some level of absolution. So thank you again, Mr. President, and thank you for being here.
Thank you, Senator Art. Senator DeFrancisco?
It's my understanding that Senator Kennedy would like to open the resolution for co-sponsorship. If you do not want to co-sponsor, please notify the chair.
The resolution is open for co-sponsorship. Should you choose not to be a co-sponsor, please indicate at the chair.
And Mr. President, could we have just a short moment of silence to remember those who died in that storm?
I would ask all present to please rise and join us in a moment of silent reflection of all those who lost their lives in the storm in Western New York. Our condolences, Mrs. Burton.